Now, since very long, I was having a project in my to-do list to make a messaging system using LoRa communication so that we don't need to rely on any GPRS, GSM or Wi-Fi based connectivity. As it is working on LoRa, so we will be able to send and receive messages within kilometers of range. Well, that will be definitely helpful for all those who go on to tracking or some remote locations where there is no internet connectivity at all. Isn't that an interesting project to be made? Well, I find it interesting, but I didn't get a time to work on that. But when I received this product from Lilygo, I was like, wow, this is way better than what I thought to make. So this is Lilygo T-Echo, which looks like a walkie-talkie at a first glance, but trust me, it is quite interesting and useful gadget. And in this video, I'll be covering about the complete specifications of this product. Not only that, I'll also be guiding you about how to use this product or program this using Arduino IDE. I'll also guide you how to flash the Meshtastic firmware in this device, which will ultimately help us to connect our device with our smartphone and will be able to send and receive messages from our smartphone through LoRa communication and can do much more things using it. So this is one of that video which I'll suggest not to skip, as this video got a lot of new things in it every minute. So let's quickly get started. So this is how I received the product from Lilygo. On the front, we get to see all the different modules along with their port on which they are connected. We'll talk more about it in the specifications part. Now on the back, we don't have anything informative. So now let's quickly open the box. So inside the box, we get the main T-Echo board along with its antenna and a USB data cable. That was all about the box content. Now if you want to get one for yourself, well, you can get it from the official Lilygo website, whose link is down in the description of this video. Now here, do select the proper frequency according to your location. I selected the 433 MHz as I live in India. Now talking about the specification of this board then. This is based on Nordic NRF52840 controller, which is based on ARM Cortex M4 clocked at 64 MHz with built-in BLE, Thread, Zigbee and NFC communication. Then it has onboard 2 MB of flash memory and 2 MB of RAM. For LoRa communication, it uses Semtech SX1262 transceiver module, and this board also has built-in GPS module and 850 mAh battery built-in. And everything comes well packaged in a nice looking ABS plastic casing. This device also has two buttons on the side, one touchpad on the top and two LEDs on the front. And to visualize the data, we have the 1.54 inch e-paper display on the front, and this display comes with an inbuilt backlight for better visualization in the dark environment. So that was all about the specifications. Now before I guide you with how to program this board using Arduino IDE, why not to thank the sponsor of our video first. This video is sponsored by LTM, and they came up with an amazing product called as LTM365. So LTM365 is an electronics product design platform that unites PCB design, MCAD, data management and teamwork. So with LTM365, you can do the PCB designing task. You can share your projects over web for review purposes. It do cover sharing your PCB file to mechanical team so that they can create the mechanical product package based on your PCB. Then it also provides centralized cloud storage, so you don't need to rely on one single computer for your files. It also helps you with managing your components and get real-time supply chain data for your components. It also allows multiple people to work on single project. And in the end, it also helps you with sending your design to final manufacturing units. So LTM365 takes care of all other tasks, so you put more time and effort in making something creative and useful. And the good part is, you can try out its free version as well. I'll leave its free trial version link down in the description of this video, so do check that out. And now, let us start with this video. So for programming this board using Arduino IDE, first we need to install the Nordic boards packages in our Arduino IDE. For that, you just need to go to Arduino preferences and here just click on this icon, and in the new line, you need to paste this link which I'll be providing in the description of this video. Click on OK once again, then you can go to tools, then into board, then into boards manager. And here just type out NRF52, press enter, and you need to install this board's packages, which I have already installed in my computer. After that, just click on the close icon, and here now you can select the right board by going to tools, then to boards, then here into Adafruit NRF2, and here you have to select the Nordic NRF52840. Okay, so this is the correct board through which we can upload the code onto our Lilygo T-Echo board. Now we need some example codes to work with this board, and for that you have to go to this official GitHub repository of T-Echo board, and you just need to download the zip file. First of all, after downloading the zip file, just go into that folder, and here into the library section, you just need to copy all this library files, and you can go to your documents into Arduino, into libraries, and you can paste all those libraries here. In case if you have those library already installed, you can just click on the replace button, which will replace all the existing libraries. Okay, so these are the necessary libraries for running the example code. So Lilygo did a great task of providing all these libraries in a one folder so that we can copy and paste it in Arduino IDE so that we don't get any compiling errors because of libraries. So after installing, you can go to the same folder, and now into the examples folder, here are all the example codes that you can try out on your T-Echo board. Okay, I'll just let you know by uploading only one single example code. The rest of all codes you can try out on your side. Okay, I will go to the GPS one, and I'll open the gps.ino file. I'll maximize this window, and this is the code that will help us to get the GPS coordinates from this T-Echo board. Okay, so now what I'll do is I'll select the right board, which is already selected, and after that I'll select the right COM port, and I will straight away hit the upload button. Okay, so the code is successfully uploaded onto the board, and on our board we are able to see the Lilygo on the screen. And if I open the serial monitor, okay, so I'm getting the data. So it is date 13, month is 4, that's April, year 2023. So this is today's date on which I'm doing the shooting right now. And I'm not getting the location data. So I guess GPS is not working here inside the indoors. So I'll take this board near to the window and let's observe the data.
So when I placed this device near to the window, I started getting the latitude and longitude data on the serial monitor. So the GPS example code is working perfectly fine using Arduino IDE. And similarly, you can upload all the other example codes provided by the company and test out on this Lilygo T-Echo board.
So after learning about how to program this board using Arduino IDE, let us move ahead and learn how to install the Meshtastic firmware in this device. And Meshtastic firmware will help you to send messages from your mobile application using LoRa communication. So let me guide you. So first of all, you need to go to this official GitHub repository, which contains all the different versions of the firmware. So the latest version is 2.1.8, but you will get all the older versions here. Okay, so for downloading the firmware, you just need to go to the assets, and here you just need to click on the firmware.zip file. It will download one zip file into your computer. After downloading, just go to your downloads folder, and here is the firmware folder. Double click on this folder and it will open up all the different kind of firmwares. Now there are a firmware for a specific board in this folder. For example, this firmware is for Meshtastic core device, this for REC4631 chipset, this is for T-Echo, which is with us right now, then we have for T-Beam, T-Lora. So we have different firmware for different devices. For our case, for this particular Echo board, we'll be selecting this firmware techiesms.uf2 file. Now the question is how to install the or flash the firmware inside the device. For that, you need to double click the top button on the board, and it will be acting as a removable device in a computer. So it is detected here in my case. So as you can see, the current.uf2 is the current firmware inside this device. So what we can do now is we can go to downloads folder, select the firmware file, which is this one, and just drag and drop this into the removable device. So it will now install the firmware in it, and we have successfully installed the firmware. It was that easy and that straightforward. Now this board will restart and it will start running the Meshtastic firmware version 2.1.8. So that's how you can easily install the firmware. Now let's go on to the Meshtastic mobile application and let us see how to pair this Echo device with our mobile phone and how to use it further. So first of all, you need to download this Meshtastic application on your smartphone. After that, just open the application, and here you'll find our T-Echo device. Just click on it and pair it via Bluetooth. Provide the code shown in the Echo device. And with this, we have successfully paired our Echo board. And now we can see a lot of information about this board, like its device ID, product name, and also it shows how much battery is left inside the device. Not only that, we can also see a complete log of location data with timestamp. We can also visualize its location on map widget, and the main part, we can send message to other Echo devices from this application, which is awesome. So let's pair another device with a different smartphone and let's try to communicate via LoRa. So here, as you can see, I put both the phones on airplane mode and only the Bluetooth is enabled. And if I send message from here, let's see what happens. Okay, so I received the message on other device and I can read the message on the Echo device as well as the smartphone. So we are successfully able to communicate via LoRa. Yaar, ek like to banta hai is kamal ke application ke liye. So now the question is, how long we can transmit and receive data using this device? And to test it out, we went outside with the device and started the range test. So we were on the roadside and initially it was LoS connection, but soon after some distance, it was no longer a line of sight, but still we were able to get the data. And after walking more than a kilometer, we were not receiving any more data. So we got a range of 1.2 kilometers between these two devices, which means we can send and receive data within 1.2 kilometers of range without any internet connectivity, which is really very helpful in some remote location or in the tracking location. Not only that, I can visualize the location of both the devices on the mobile application as it has GPS built in. I can even see the log of the other device, which contains the location coordinates along with the timestamp. And what I think is, if we have more number of these devices, the range can definitely be increased, as one message can hop from one device to other device via mesh communication, and this can help us to increase the range. So if you are thinking of for going on some tracking with your group, well, do carry this kind of device with you for, you know, emergency communication. Also, this time we didn't put any LoRa transceiver at the height, but what I think, if we install this LoRa transceiver at the height, we can definitely increase the range. I didn't try that in this video, but maybe in some of the Instagram reels or YouTube shorts, I can try it out. So do follow us on the social media platforms as well. So that was the great device and a great mobile application for LoRa communication. Well, Meshtastic has a lot more things built in which are not covered in this video. And what I think, I need to make a separate video just on the mobile application to, you know more in detail about that application. Well, you can ask me for making a video on that app, particularly down in the comments of the video. Also, do share your thoughts on this T-Echo device. Is it really useful? Are you trying to get one for yourself, or it's just a useless thing? Well, feel free to share your thoughts down in the comments of the video. And yeah, that was it about this video, and I am just ending this video here and now. Just wait for my next interesting, informative video. Until then, explore, learn, share with me, techiesms.